Everybody, I'm Actors, and I'm coming back to you guys with another dope sneaker review. You couldn't tell from the title of this video, we're going to be reviewing the Jordan 1 Biohacks. Shout out to my people over at 39 Castles for supplying these sneakers. If you guys ever found yourselves in St. Louis and looking for a dope sneaker store to shop in, 39 Castles is definitely the way to go. Anyways, let's get right into the unboxing. So in this Jordan 1, we just have the normal Jordan 1 red and black box right here. Classic, iconic, you always know there's going to be some dope sneakers in these boxes. Lifting up the lid and removing the wrapping paper and whoa! First impressions of this sneaker is that there are just a lot going on here. Seeing these in photos compared to seeing these on hand is so different. I mean, these things are just absolutely crazy. What the hell are those? This right here, too, Gucci, is probably one of the most hyped Jordan 1 releases of this year.
Hell no, it looks like a unicorn took a dump on the Travis Scott ones.
No, actually have a closer look at these because I think these are straight fire.
Nope, I am not going near those. I'm out, cousin.
Well then. So my opinion is obviously different from his, and yours might be the same or different, which is why in this video, we're going to figure out if the Jordan 1 biohack is worth it. So let's roll that B-roll. Before we get into this review, please like, comment, share, and subscribe this video. My goal is to get 4,000 watch hours by the end of this year, and right now we're at 1,600, so any form of support would just be awesome. First, as always, we're going to give you some background. So this sneaker is called the Jordan 1 Tokyo Biohack. And the reason why Jordan Brand's kind of been doing a lot of, you know, Japan and Tokyo inspired shoes, because, well, you know, the Olympics was supposed to be there, and well, that got canceled. But they're still releasing these dope sneakers because why not? This sneaker is inspired by the electronic and fast-moving paced city of Tokyo. So that's why we got like 9 different colors on this sneaker. It's supposed to be very eye-catching and absolutely crazy. And I gotta say, I think they've done a really good job. These sneakers released on September of this year with the retail price of $170. Starting with the sole of the sneaker, we have an all-black outsole, which is your standard Jordan 1 tech. Nothing too special going on here. Coming to the midsole though, we have something very interesting. It's a normal Jordan 1 sole, but it's in this mint green. Now when I first saw these sneakers, I actually thought they were supposed to be glow in the dark, which kind of threw me off for a second, but nope, it's just mint green, which is actually something that I really like a lot. I couldn't imagine the sneaker being as crazy with just a normal white sole. So this mint green really helps out a lot, making this sneaker pop out a lot more. And I would definitely love seeing Jordan Brand do a lot more unique midsoles like this. Coming up to the uppers of the sneaker, now this is where stuff gets absolutely insane. I mean, I'm just gonna go ahead and try to run through all the colors that we have here. I mean, we have a brown right here towards the back, black middle portion right there. And this sneaker features a very sleek silver swoosh logo, which in my opinion doesn't work on a lot of sneakers, but on this one, I think it's actually really cool. It's made in leather and actually makes the sneaker really shiny too. Overlapping and continuing on the middle section, we have this blue suede right here. And this wraps all the way around the toe. And by the way, the suede material used in the sneaker is absolutely amazing and really top notch. Swooping into the middle section, now things are even more crazy here. We kind of have this Tiffany blue right here for the toe box. And then the tongue is done in this really nice orange mesh. And we have this very cool stitched on Nike Air tag on the top. Let's go over the details real quick. We have blue stitching around it. The Air logo is done in pink, which contrasts really nicely with the black background. Really awesome, it's one of the cooler details of the sneaker. And the tongue also has exposed foam on it, which gives me kind of like an off-white vibe. Also on the tongue, if you look on the back of it, it's done in pink, which is a really out there color combo. For the laces of the sneaker, it comes straight out of the factory with black laces, but you also have an option of swapping them out for pink laces, which I would highly recommend. I mean, I think that would make the sneaker even look even more crazy. Also, a really strange detail, if you pull back the top eyelid right here, it actually exposes some neon green. So I can definitely see people not lacing the top of these just so they can show off that color. Definitely an interesting detail to have. Back to the heel of the sneaker, now we see a couple touches back here as well. We mostly see just the brown suede back here, which also kind of gives me like that Travis Scott Jordan 1 vibes. And we also see a Tiffany blue leather patch back here, which is pretty funny. I feel like the designers of the sneaker was like, whoa, this back is not popping enough. Bam! Tiffany blue patch, there we go. And it definitely does do the trick. Moving on to the interior of the sneaker, now this might be actually the brightest portion of the sneaker. I mean, the inside is just completely covered in pink, and it even gets exposed towards the top of the sneaker. And I like that it does that because it helps give the sneaker a little bit more pizzazz. And lastly, you can see that we have a blue insole with a pink Nike Air logo on it. And that about wraps up this sneaker. So now begs the question, are these sneakers worth it? So definitely quality-wise, I'll definitely give this a good 9 out of 10. Now, suede is a really good and quality material, but the problem with it, as always, is that it always gets destroyed easily. So it is a little harder to take care of. But other than that, it's really nice, leather's really good on it too, and really well-made shoe. Now, for styling and wearability, well, that's a whole other beast to tackle now. For style and wearability, though, I'm gonna have to give this a 7 out of 10. Now, me personally, I just love the look of this sneaker, but not a lot of people are gonna get it, though. And also, it'll probably be pretty hard to pick an outfit for this sneaker. The way that I would style this probably is to wear just all kind of like colored neutral clothing besides these, and just have these as like your main kicker. And just have these as kind of like your main kicker for the outfit. Value-wise, I'm gonna have to give this a 7 out of 10 as well. I mean, these things did retail for $170, but resale is much more than that now. You're going anywhere between like $250 to over $300, which might be a lot for a lot of people. But this is a Jordan 1, so if you buy these sneakers and hold them for a little bit, I bet you that the prices will definitely go up a little bit, so you can kind of see this as an investment shoe. So overall, this has a really good value. Also, for sizing of the sneaker, it is a Jordan 1, so I would say go true to size. But everybody's feet's different, so I always recommend to try on a pair of Jordan 1s before buying. So my final verdict of the sneaker, I would say that these sneakers are worth it. I mean, I think these are just super crazy and really unique. And I always encourage my viewers to be above basic, and these are definitely the move. And I truly do believe that prices are going to go up, so if you guys are looking at this sneaker, please cop them before prices go up. And that is all there is to it to this sneaker. So the Jordan 1 Tokyo Biohacks. What'd you guys think about it? Like, comment, share this video if you guys enjoyed it. And last, but certainly not least, subscribe. I'll see y'all in the next one.